Ito po ang upang ano? Miss Universe?
Yes, sir. Nagalo po yan.
Yo.
Big mic, big. Ready mo lang ha.
Sir, tagal ba natin hihintay?
Sir, bigyan nyo lang down, sir.
Sir, bakit po tayo nagpunta ngayon dito? Kasi pwede naman po hindi
lang. Bigyan niya, bigyan niya ng
space. Sasabit kami ng mga documents.
Bigyan niya ng space, sir. Bigyan niya.
Kasama yung abogado ko.
Sir, ito nga po, no? Ano po yung concern niyo ng presence yung ngayon dito? More than the...
Kasi sa... Excuse.
Bigyan niya, bigyan niya, Dan.
Salita kasi igurot yung matago-tago, di ba? Pero hindi nagtatago.
Sir, yung reason po ng pagpunta nyo ngayon dito? Ano po yun, sir? Ang reason po ng pagpunta nyo ngayon dito?
Hindi, para mag-submit ng documents nga.
Sir, ano po ang reaction nyo doon? Ano po statement sa lahat ng allegations against you, sir? Especially this murder complaint against you?
Ano?
Ano reaction nyo, sir?
Murder complaint. Eh, normal lang yung reaksyon na sasagutin natin sa court kung sasagutin.
Sir, in essence, anong sinabi niyo sa counter-affidavit?
Anong sinabi niyo sa counter-affidavit?
Anong sinabi niyo?
Wala, hindi ko matandaan sa dami.
Sis lang. Pasok mo na.
Are you denying, sir, involvement?
Sis lang.
Tignan niyo, baka magkapa kayo, ha?
Sir, dinidinay niyo ba yung involvement niyo, sir? Ha? Dinidinay niyo yung involvement niyo, sir, sa kaso?
101.
Sis lang.
Sir, i-address na lang ninyo sa ilaban kay Attorney Balisong and Company, kasi hindi ako lawyer, baka madisbar ako kahit hindi ako lawyer.
Yes, ang motion for inhibition, ang purpose nito is to take away yung preliminary investigation from the Department of Justice. So we cited two grounds. First, yung issue on impartiality, because the respondent, DG Bantag, is entitled to an impartial and independent tribunal. We stated in our motion that in the pronouncements of the Department of Justice Secretary, he had been accusing our client of committing these crimes being imputed against him. Nakita naman natin yun sa interview. So lahat ng interviews ng Secretary of Justice, we had it attached to the motion, no? So aside from that, we also raised an issue on jurisdiction. Also, we go back first dun sa issue ng impartiality. Not necessarily the members of the prosecuting or the investigating panel, but because the investigating panel is under the control and supervision of the department secretary as per provision of section 112 PD 1275, we deem it necessary na alisin na lang kasi they are under the control of the secretary. Besides, under yung Department Circular Number 027 dated July 13, 2022 which was issued by the secretary himself, no? Eh nakalagay doon na he has the power to review yung resolution ng investigating panel under section 1. So under section 3 sinasabi naman doon na he has the power to motu proprio make a review on the resolution and substitute yung ano yung findings ng investigating panel. So that's our fear. So with due respect to the Department of Justice and the investigating panel, we are asking the Department of Justice to inhibit. On the second ground, for lack of jurisdiction, no? We stated in our motion that the Department of Justice has no jurisdiction on these cases. It falls within the jurisdiction of the ombudsman to conduct the necessary or the requisite preliminary investigation. As per provision of the Constitution, you look at Article 11, Section 13, Paragraph 1, which gives the power of the ombudsman to investigate all cases committed by public officials by public officials when it appears to be illegal, improper, no? Those are cases falls within the jurisdiction of the ombudsman to investigate. It doesn't make any distinction whether these crimes falls within the jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan or the regular courts, no? We also cited the provision of Section 15 in relation to Section 11 of Republic Act 6770 or the Ombudsman Act of 1989, which gives the power to the Ombudsman to investigate cases falling within the jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan and in conjunction with the decision of the Supreme Court in the case of Uy versus Sandigan Bayan, where the Supreme Court reiterated that the Ombudsman has the power to investigate cases like this, whether it falls within the jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan or the regular courts. And very importantly, the Supreme Court said in this case that the ombudsman can take over the investigation of these cases at any stage of the proceedings from any government agency.
Okay. Sir, reaction regarding the statement of Roy Mabasa, this is another delaying of the justice para sa kanyang kapatid, sir.
This is not a delaying tactic, no? Because we are raising a very serious issue of jurisdiction and issue on impartiality. This is well within the right of the respondent. This is a serious crime and we cannot just disregard all these things, no? So we are invoking the constitutional right of the respondent here because we also requested for some documents which are not clear and which were not submitted by the PNP and the NBI. We made a formal request and we just received it today. So these are very material matters which should be considered before submitting the counter affidavit. So it is not at all a delaying tactic. No?
Sir, ano yung deputized ng DOJ ng ombudsman? Like, wala bang conflict dyan na gusto nyo talaga ombudsman?
No, hindi naman dinideputize ng DOJ ang ombudsman. It is per provision. It is as per provision of the law. So dapat tignan ito ng investigating panel and inhibit itself because as per provision of the law, sinasabi nga natin ang constitution mismo, I cited Article 11, Section 13, Paragraph 1, no? And in relation to the provision of Republic Act 6770, the Ombudsman Act of 1989, Section 15 and Section 11 respectively, in conjunction with the decision of the Supreme Court in Uy versus Sandigan Bayan.
Okay. So sir, sa tingin niyo, pagbibigyan itong inhibition na pinayon po ninyo ng prosecution or ng nag-handle ng kaso, at the same time, kailan sir ang next preliminary investigation?
I hope the investigating panel will study it carefully because we have laid a very solid ground, no? For them to inhibit from this case. Aside from the issue on impartiality, the issue on jurisdiction is a serious matter which should be considered by them. Now, the next preliminary investigation will be set after the resolution of our motion for inhibition. Wala pa because the parties, the complainants and the NBI and the PNP were given 7 days from today to file their comment on our motion for inhibition.
Pero si General Sir, kanina sumumpati sa
my prepared actually na counter affidavit if the because we were anticipating na kung ayaw payagan ng panel na extend namin yung filing ng counter affidavit because of our pending motion ay sana magfa-file kami ng counter affidavit ad cautelam. Ibig sabihin, in anticipation for whatever will happen in our motion, at least naka-file na kami. But that is only partial because, as I have said, we requested documents from the PNP and the NBI and the prosecuting panel for us to be provided because hindi clear yung iba at saka yung list of persons of interest. We need that in the preparation of our counter affidavit. Of course, the CCTV footages which caught the alleged gunman na sinasabi nila yun ang basis nila to trace Escorial as the gunman. So we requested all of this from the NBI, the PNP, and the prosecuting panel. Yeah, it's only one. It's only one actually. It's only the motion for inhibition. Wala pang counter affidavit because the investigating panel suspended the proceedings muna, no? Pending resolution of our motion for inhibition. Well, generally we have denied, no? We have